I am a clinical psychologist and a runway model. I have spinal muscular atrophy type 2. I was born this way. I'm sure we could cut to photos of me right now as a kid looking cute, but we're gonna cut back to me. Let's focus on sex, intimacy, relationships, and disability. Can you handle it? I joke a lot that I'm Miss Wheelchair New York by night and clinical psychologist by day. I'm on Tinder. I'm out there dating. It really supplements what I do as a clinician because I know exactly what my patients with disabilities encounter. People have asked me many times online dating, can you function sexually? And I always answer back, yes, can you? I remember when I first moved to New York and started dating, I was just, you know, being rejected, having inappropriate questions asked about me, like, oh, hi, what's your name? Oh, can you have sex? You know, you really don't start out conversations like that. The problem lies in the fact that we don't see a lot of people with disability in the media. One night I got a call from my friend who said, hey, I found this pageant online, the Miss Wheelchair New York pageant. I thought to myself, let me do that pageant and let me try and win it. If I could wear high heels, then they can. If I could dress sexy or do my hair, then they can do it too. There are numerous stereotypes that are still associated with disability. Being asexual, being unable to have sex, we don't make good romantic partners. So the notion of sex in society that we see on TV often shows these physically fit people having traditional forms of sex. You don't have to be able to do the standard throw down notions of sex. Anything can be sexy. It could be a fluttering eyelash on a cheek. When you don't see yourself in those magazines or part of those models, then you internalize that image and think that, okay, I guess I'm not sexy. People with disabilities have the same sexual needs and desires and appetite for romance and intimacy that everyone else has. It's part of being human. My name is Dr. Danielle Sheypuk, and this is my brief but spectacular take on making disability sexy.